First of all, what I'm calling for, the title of my book, okay, which is okay, Free Women, Free Men, I'm calling for an end to the sex war okay, in feminism. Okay. Women are well launched now. Okay, so this kind of, this reflex, snide, you know, put downs of men that are everywhere, this has got to stop. Right? Now, I notice, you know, wherever I go in the world, actually, that upper middle class career women are very unhappy. They're very unhappy, okay, even though they have achieved a certain status. What I'm saying is that feminists have to stop blaming men for their own unhappiness. The unhappiness is due, I believe, to huge systemic changes that women, for thousands of years, women had their own world. There was the world of women, and there was the world of men. And the sexes didn't have that much to do with each other, okay? This is a brand new experiment to have this new system where now women can be economically independent now. They're no longer dependent on father or husband or brother, okay, for their sustenance, right? And they're working side by side with men in the workplace, right? This is an experiment. It's never happened before, right? I'm saying in the book that we may have to accept a certain amount of tension between the sexes in the workplace. Right? The feminist idea that if we can just suppress men enough, women will be happy. I say no, okay? I say, okay, and it's on the basis of my own experience as a child in Italian-American immigrant community, okay, is that what women have lost is the old solidarity that they once had when they totally ruled the private sphere. The women's life all day long was with other women once, multi-generational, older women, okay, as well as the children, right? It was a huge tribal experience. And now what women are feeling is a sense of isolation and loneliness, disconnection, okay, from their old function. I'm not saying to go back. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying stop blaming men, all right? Like, for example, these marches that just happened, okay? The women were exhilarated. They were almost hysterical, okay? I don't think it had anything to do with feminism or anti-Trump or anything like that. I thought it was that women suddenly felt that surge of happiness again for being with other women, all right? Right? You can actually see it in the Odyssey when Odysseus is washed up naked and alone. He's lost his ship, you know, on the shores of Phaeacia, and he wakes to the sound of girls, women's voices laughing and singing and so on. It's the princess Nausicaa going down to do the laundry on the shore. Okay, and actually that is exactly what was going on up until fairly recently, where women were all together. They did all the chores together. They did the laundry. They did the cooking. I mean, I can remember this from my childhood in Endicott, New York, upstate New York, among the immigrants. Italian women. All four of my grandparents, plus my mother, were born in Italy. So I actually had that experience, the experience that went on for thousands of years in the agrarian era. Well, women all together. In fact, my mother described as a small child in Italy how all the women would get together to do the laundry and go up the hill to Il Sorgo, which was a fountain cut out of the side of the mountain, probably went back thousands of years to the Roman period and so on. She remembered the singing, you know, the picnicking, et cetera, okay? So even though people were laboring physically in the agrarian era, there was a happiness, okay, a sense of identity. There was no quest for identity. Now, it's no place for an independent thinker, okay? If you were an independent thinker, you had no options as a woman except to become a nun. Okay, so I know, okay? I know I would have been a nun, okay, 100 years ago. All right, I know it, okay? And obviously, you know, communities are intellectually repressive in their own way. Nevertheless, we're in a period now of quest for identity, tremendous pressures on young people to form their own identity separate from those old automatic tribal and community affiliations. So I think there's a tremendous, as a classroom teacher, you know, of now, you know, more than 40 years, I can see this, and it's really, there's a tremendous sense of psychological dislocation among young people.